Hi, I'm Tula. Today we're going to be doing a stretch and balance class together. So we're just going to start with a little warm-up. We're just going to take a couple steps forward and back with a little toe tap. Alrighty, in a couple seconds we're going to just do some marching in place. Alrighty, last one. So let's just take some steps. We can include our arms in this, just warming up our whole body. About 15 more seconds of this, then we're gonna do some stretching of our arms. Alrighty, so for these arm stretches, you can continue marching or you can stand in place, but we're just going to start off with a crossbody arm stretch. So you're just going to grab that elbow, keep your shoulders down, try not to shrug up too much. Just pull it across your body. If it's more comfortable, you can hold on your lower arm or up on your shoulder. And switch sides. We're going to do each side for about 15 seconds. And switch. And switch. Last one. Next, we're going to bring one arm back, kind of in the middle of our back, and we're either going to hold on to our elbow up here, or if it's more comfortable, you can grab your hand, and we're just going to slightly pull it down. And we're going to do the other side, same thing. We're going to do both sides for about 15 seconds. And just pull until you feel a comfortable stretch. You don't want to feel any pain or discomfort. That'll be the same with all the stretches we do. All right, last one. Shake those arms out. Next, we're going to clasp our hands together behind our back. You can either have your palms facing towards you or away, whatever's more comfortable. And we're just going to squeeze our shoulder blades together and extend our arms out so they're straight. We're just going to hold this. Just going to open up your chest and warm up your shoulders a little bit. Alrighty, then we're going to bend at the waist. We're just going to lean over. Feel that stretch in your arms a little bit more. You can kind of move in between standing and bending. Alrighty. Come up, shake those arms out. Next, we're just going to do an overhead reach. So you're going to grab your wrist to that hand that's extending over and just slightly pull. You want to feel this stretch right here. You can also drop this arm if that's more comfortable. A couple more seconds, then we're going to switch sides. All right, check it out. And one more on each side. Switch sides, last one. Alrighty, and bring those arms down. Give them a good shake. Next, we're gonna do a little calf stretch. So we're gonna get into a small lunge. So just take a little step forward. And then we're gonna have our arms at our side or on our hips. And we're just gonna slightly bend that leg that's in front at the knee. So just a little bit while keeping this back leg straight. So we wanna feel this in our calf. And if you have a wall, you can also do it against that. So we're going to do both sides, hold it a bit for about 15 seconds. And just pushing that heel down into the ground. Ready, and switch sides. Nice job. Righty and other side. So stomping down on that back heel. Keeping your core tight, your shoulders not too slouched over. Righty and switch sides. Nice job. So bring it up. Next, we're going to go into another forward lunge. This one's going to be a little bit deeper. So you're going to take a big step forward. We're just going to bend that knee. Whoops. Get into a nice comfortable lunge. And then we're going to drop our forward, the hand that's on our forward leg side. And we're just going to reach up and over. Look up. And if you have a chair or wall next to you, you can use that for a little balance too. Alrighty, and we're gonna switch sides. So just drop that hand. So you can kind of look up towards your hand in the sky as you're stretching. Nice. All right. One more time on each side. All right. And switch. Last one. Nice job. Next, we're going to get into a lunge again, but this time we're going to take a step forward into that lunge position. Then we're going to drop this hand all the way to the ground, and we're going to reach up and over like so. So you can either be flat palm on the ground or just little fingertips for some added balance. Just going to stretch over. Nice. All right, and then we're going to do the other side. Nice job. One more on each side. Alrighty, and last one. Alrighty, good job. Next, we're going to get into a kneeling position. We're just going to take one foot, step it out forward, and then we're either going to have our hands on our hips or we can have them out for a little balance. And we're just going to keep our hips aligned and just bend, lean into that knee. So again, you don't want to lean too far that there's any pain or discomfort. Just make sure you feel a nice, comfortable stretch. Alrighty, and other side. And one more on each side. Alrighty, last one. Couple more seconds. Alright, good job. So then we're going to stay on our knees, but this time we're going to put our hands out in front of us, and we're going to take one leg and stick it directly out to the side. And you don't want it to be in front of you or behind you, so try and keep it in line with your hips. And then we're going to put our hands on the ground. You're going to have most of your weight on your hands, but what you're going to try and do is just kind of lower onto those hands, kind of feel this right in your leg, and try and keep this leg straight. Or if it's easier, you can add a little bit of bend into it. We're going to do two of these on both sides. Alrighty, so bring this leg in. We're going to go ahead and switch. So again, you have most of your weight on these hands, but you want to just feel a little bit of pressure on that leg. Alrighty, bring that leg in and switch. Alrighty, last one. You're doing great. Alrighty, and then bring those legs together. And then from here, we're going to get into a downward dog. So you can choose to put your hands down, lift your legs up, and then you can do some pedaling of your heels right here for a little calf stretch. And another option is to be on your forearms if you would prefer to do that. And then in a couple seconds, we're gonna go down into a cobra. So we're just gonna slowly lower and come down onto the mat, feet pointing away from you. You're just gonna push your shoulders down, squeeze your shoulder blades together, look up towards the ceiling, and just take a couple deep breaths here. All right. ready. Then we're going to tuck our toes under and go back up into that downward dog. Hold this for a couple more seconds. Alrighty, and then back down into Cobra. Make sure your shoulders aren't too hunched up. You want to keep those nice and relaxed. About 5 more seconds. Alrighty. So next we're going to sit on the ground and we're going to extend both our legs out in front of us. And then we're going to take our right leg and cross it over next to our left knee. And then what we're going to do is take our left arm, put that elbow against that knee, and twist. So you want to look away from your legs. You can have your hand on the ground for balance, or you can actually reach it up and away. Keep your shoulder blades down. Righty, and then we're going to switch sides. One more time on each side. Make sure you're remembering to take nice deep breaths. Last one of these. Alrighty. So next we're going to bring our feet flat on the ground. We're just going to keep our knees bent, placing our hands behind us with our fingers pointing away from us. We're just going to keep our arms straight and slowly scoot our body away from our hands so we can feel the stretch in our biceps. Just hold this for about 15 seconds. All right, and then scoot your body back up, shake those arms out, and then we're going to do that one more time. All righty, so arms back, slowly scoot away, keep your head up and shoulders down. Couple more seconds of this one. Alrighty, nice job. So next we're going to move onto our back. And we're going to start with our knees bent. And we're going to take our right leg and cross it over so that our right ankle is on top of our left knee. And then what we're going to do is grab the back of our left leg. And we're just going to slowly bring it towards us. So you're kind of pulling towards your chest. And the pulling part is optional. You could just hold your leg up there, but don't pull past any point of like discomfort or pain. Just a nice, comfortable stretch. Alrighty, and then we're gonna bring our legs down and we're gonna switch sides. together, taking some nice deep breaths. And slowly lower and switch sides. Alrighty, bring it down. Last one on this side. Alrighty, and bring your legs down. And next we're gonna lay our legs flat on the ground, and we're gonna take one knee up in the air and cross it over to one side. So you're gonna take that opposite arm and reach away from that knee that's crossed over. And you can use this hand to sort of keep your knee on the ground here, or you can kind of let it rise up. Alrighty, and back to center. We're gonna do the other side. And back to center, we're gonna do one more on each side. Taking some nice deep breaths in this stretch. Dropping this shoulder to the ground. You don't want to be too hunched over. Alrighty, and back to center. Last one. Seconds. Then we're going to come up to a sitting position. Alrighty, so bring your legs back together. Go ahead and sit up, and then we're going to get into a butterfly. So you're going to have your bottoms of your feet together. You can kind of lean forward, try and get your knees as close to the ground as you can. Just going to hold this for a couple seconds. Take some nice deep breaths. Just leaning forward so you feel a comfortable stretch in your legs. Alrighty, and then coming up, you can stay in a butterfly position or you can cross your legs. And we're just gonna keep our back nice and straight. We're just gonna do some neck circles, taking some deep breaths. In a couple seconds, we're going to switch directions. Alrighty, and opposite way. Alrighty, and then back at center, we're just going to lean to the side. You can sort of lightly grab onto one side of your head if that's comfortable, or you can just kind of lean side to side. And then we'll go forward and backwards. And then we're gonna end in child's pose. I'm gonna hold this for about 30 seconds, but feel free to hold it for as long as you would like. Kind of creep your hands forward. Take some nice deep breaths. All right, and that is